Israeli airstrikes struck the building where the Associated Press and Al Jazeera are housed. My plane chains arrived. I think that's an accident. They don't like Al Jazeera. I think it's a good paper. A little much for me this morning.
Saturday morning, Israel struck Gaza City again. So far in the Gaza Strip, at least 126 people have been killed, 31 of them children. In another strike, the military said they were targeting Hamas commanders operating from a building. In retaliation on Saturday morning, Hamas said it fired a salvo of rockets at southern Israel. Both sides have fired hundreds of rockets at each other. So far in Israel, 7 people have been killed, one of them a 5-year-old boy. There's been violence between Israelis too. In an unprecedented wave of mob violence, Arab Israelis have attacked synagogues and Jewish Israelis have set mosques on fire. The Overnight on Friday, Arab Israelis clashed with the police in the northern town of Jisr al-Zarqa. And in the mixed Arab-Jewish city of Lod, there were more clashes too. More than 750 people have been arrested this week, police said. And for Palestinians in the West Bank on Saturday, it was Nakba, or Catastrophe Day, when they lament the creation of Israel in 1948.
Demonstrations have been taking place around the world against the violence between Israel and Hamas. In Baghdad, protesters burned Israeli flags as people chanted and waved Palestinian flags. In London, lines of protesters waving banners and Palestinian flags made their way through the streets, calling on the UK government to take immediate action to help end the fighting. In Gaza, at least 139 people have been killed, including 39 children. Israel has reported 9 dead. Thousands of people gathered in protests across France, including in Lyon, Bordeaux, and Strasbourg, and about 300 people demonstrated in Montpellier. Crimes against the Palestinians, she says, are denounced and are recognized by the UN. The colonization of the Palestinian territories by Israel are condemned by the UN, and despite everything, the international community does not act. It started, but it's so slow and it's heartbreaking. In Paris, a ban on protests by the authorities didn't stop people trying. Supporters of the Palestinians began to gather on Saturday afternoon, but were immediately dispersed by the police.
Europe is starting to open up for the summer. Despite still being under a state of calamity, Portugal has announced it will welcome tourists from across Europe this Monday. The United Kingdom will provide most of the visitors. It's vaccinated a greater proportion of its population than anywhere else in the continent. One Portuguese businessman said there'll be a huge influx of very happy people who have not been able to travel for a year and a half.
Well, we're very, very pleased that the news has been announced that the British will be welcome to Kent from Monday. Absolutely delighted.
And in Italy, the beaches are opening as it prepares to welcome back tourists from Europe and Israel. Sunday, they'll no longer have to quarantine on arrival. They'll just need a negative coronavirus test result before they set off. In Spain, it's a similar story, as beaches
is
on the Costa
del Sol
reopened. And on Saturday, it was Spanish tourists.
I'm wondering if the coronavirus card is the mark of the beast. Without one, you can't travel, you can't do stuff.
And toasted their newfound freedoms as restaurants, bars, and pubs reopened for the first time in 7 months.
The island of Taiwan, which had great success in containing COVID-19, imposed new restrictions in the capital Taipei on Saturday after seeing its worst outbreak since the pandemic began. Residents have been panic buying basic products like noodles and tinned food as the government introduced stricter social distancing measures and put a limit of 5 people on indoor gatherings. In Singapore, too, there's been a tightening of COVID-19 measures. From Sunday until June the 13th, gatherings will be limited to 2 people, and restaurants can only provide delivery or takeout services. Meanwhile, in India, the country's 2 biggest cities have reported a drop in daily infections. But the government is warning that a devastating surge is spreading in rural areas, where more than 800 million people live. Health agencies have increased resources in rural areas to ensure a more thorough testing and vaccination program.
The World Health Organization is calling on rich nations to delay vaccinating children against COVID-19 to ensure those most at risk in all countries receive protection. One such place is South Africa, where many healthcare workers still haven't been vaccinated despite the deadliness of the local variant.
There'll be enough for everybody that actually does want to get vaccinated, you know. I think that's my only concern. Also taking into consideration what happened yesterday, you know, people had vouchers, people had appointments confirmed, but you get to the front and you've been waiting the whole day, and then you don't get vaccinated. So let's hope it gets better.
If the WHO plea is met, it would mean wealthier countries donating doses destined for children to its global vaccine sharing scheme.
I understand why some countries want to vaccinate their children and adolescents. But right now, I urge them to reconsider and to instead donate vaccines to COVAX.
In some places, the vaccination of younger people is already well advanced. On Thursday, the US started to give the jab to 17 million adolescents aged 12 to 15, a key part of President Joe Biden's strategy to push the country towards herd immunity. World leaders and representatives from tech companies have been holding talks on how to prevent violent extremism online. The meeting, held by video conference, was launched by New Zealand's Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern and is known as the Christchurch Call. 2 years ago, 51 Muslim worshippers died in a mass shooting at a mosque in the city. The white supremacist behind the killings live-streamed the massacre on Facebook. Ardern believes we need to know more about how online radicalization works to be able to counter it.
We need to understand how algorithms, at-risk internet users and extreme networks interact on the path to radicalization so that we can find ways to intervene positively.
From his residence at Fort de Brégançon, French President Emmanuel Macron co-hosted the talks. The initiative is being backed by 51 countries, including the United States, which is participating for the first time.
Give me some, whatever. Can you please eliminate imitation of the singer of La La La, God? Firm reaffirm, the power of an infinite number of infinities. What is that? Maybe part of why I'm swollen is because I've been drinking so much water. But that's what I'm thirsty for. Please give me a zone of protection, God, maybe 6 feet. Firm reaffirm, the power of an infinite number of infinities. Yes, you know. Yeah. fat boy, fat boy, fat boy, fat boy. let me know which is Bobby Sherman and which isn't. Stop recording.